All right, so we're back with another chapter breakdown. The official release for the current chapter, chapter 319, just dropped. And the way that Tabata written this chapter, it was almost as if the captains were taking turns who gets bodied by Lucifaro. I mean, this guy is a menace to society, because the way I would describe a menace to society is like a person who is like watching this video and haven't hit subscribe yet with notification bells on and leave a like on the video. You know, those kind of people, you know what I'm talking about? I think I'm on the money with that one. Anyways, let's dive in deep into this chapter breakdown, because there is one thing I noticed, and I want to start with the salamander on top of Twilight Valhalla, the little mini house. Because we already know that in Twilight Valhalla's spell, everyone is gaining magic power, and so this would mean that the salamander is also gaining magic power as well. But under this spell, I would assume that the salamander would get bigger, because we saw in episode 151, when the captains were fighting, we saw the salamander did get bigger when it was getting a boost of power from William's World Tree magic. In that episode, the salamander was humongous, and we didn't see that this chapter, so it lets me know that if William was in this fight, they would have had even more help, because William's War Tree magic can absorb magic and also transfer that over to a spirit or either to his own magic. So even though he still would have been not much of a help, but he is arcane, so it's very possible he would have had some effect even absorbing Lucifer's gravity magic. But I don't think that it would have been enough, even if you add Yami into the equation. And Yami is a very strong character, but I believe that Lucifer, he probably would have got rid of Yami first, because Yami is an attacker and he's arcane, and that dark magic is a problem for devils. And Yami would have used Death Thrust immediately, so I can't help but to think when I read this chapter how it would have played out if all the captains were there, even Kaiser. Even though I know that Lucifer most likely would have just bodied everyone, but it would have been even more impactful just knowing that there are arcane stages within this fight. Especially Yami, because Yami is a great melee character if he would have been in this fight. However, we gotta talk about the two melee characters that started off fighting Lucifer that started this onslaught. Because it makes sense the way this chapter started, that you start off with your two strongest fighting type mages. Mages who are better fighting up close, because Vegolion, he also can fit in that category as well, but he's more versatile. Where Jack and Mario Leona, the way they fight, they're kind of the same. So it makes sense why they started off this fight. However, it's crazy that Jack cannot cut Lucifer at all. Because we saw how he couldn't cut through gravity when he was fighting Dante, but eventually he used Mana Zone and had all those slashes around his body. And then we saw he was able to cut through gravity and even Dante's body magic. But once Dante hit 100%, it was kind of useless. So it makes sense against Lucifer, it'll be on a worse degree. And for Mario Leona, I'm not surprised that she cannot burn through it, because before the time skip, she couldn't burn through Zagreb's otherworld spells. And then we saw that in the time skip, when she was fighting the ancient demon, she did have trouble and eventually overcame the ancient demon, because we have seen during the 6-month time skip that her magic has greatly improved. However, despite her improvement, it doesn't mean anything to Lucifer. And this one thing I noticed in this chapter that I did not talk about in my chapter review, because in my last video I talked about that, it looks like Mario Leona lost an arm. But that was towards the end of the chapter when she tried to punch Lucifer again. But I did not notice early on that her arm was affected when Lucifer grabbed her arm. And it looks like he broke her arm early on in this fight, which I did not realize. Which seems like this is now the running thing with the Vermillions, where we see Vigolion, he already lost an arm. Mario Leona, she's losing an arm. And Leopold, he could be next if Tabata keep this up. One thing I do want to clear up though from my chapter review is that I said that Mario Leona, it seemed as though she has more durability than Asta since he took a punch, but totally forgot in that split second while recording that they are under Twilight Valhalla's spell. So we cannot use that as a feat that is more durable than Asta. Is it possible that she's more durable? It's possible. It's very possible. However, we cannot use the Twilight Valhalla spell as a feat, because they all got magic boosted. So that mana skin and that mana zone is an extra increase in defense. However, we did see Mario Leona on her Whitebeard type beat versus the 5Ls when she was about to pass out but still standing up. So you gotta take into account that she's much stronger than that now. But so is Asta, so a debate is there as far as durability. But speaking of durability, you know, Nozel is very thankful for Real's Twilight Valhalla spell to increase their durability, because the way that Lucifer did him in this chapter was embarrassing. I mean, all these guys got embarrassed, but the way that Lucifer did Nozell is almost like he took this personal. Like, he had some grudge against Nozell. Like, guy, you never met him. With Twilight Valhalla's spell activated, Nozell definitely survived death here. It's very possible because they will not die under Twilight Valhalla's spell. However, once this spell is deactivated, once Real runs out of magic, the damage that they are receiving from Lucifer will be intact. Once this spell is done, we can just easily say, yeah, Mimosa will heal them, or you can just add in Gray, she may heal Cisco Leon's arm. But let's be honest, is Gray standing within that gravity, or if Mimosa is standing within that gravity? Because by the time Rule's spell is deactivated, I'm not sure how the captains will survive this, and it could be a shocking death to one of the Magic Knight captains. But you guys comment below and tell me, do you think that any of these captains, will they die or will they be rescued? Because immediately after this fight, someone needs to save them. Someone else needs to step in, but who could it be? But that is for a different video for a different day. Because we see what happens to Fingolion in this chapter where he shoots Solomon a breath, which we already knew. This was not going to work because he used this to low-ranking devils and they got out of it. So if low-ranking devils can get out of this Salamander Breath, what do you think that Lucifer is going to do when he gets hit by the Salamander Breath, despite the extra magic boost from Twilight Valhalla? Fingolion could have easily been the biggest help in this fight if he achieved Saint Stage, which I don't think is going to happen this arc by the looks of things. Because let's be honest, Tabata could easily make Fingolion the strongest captain if he actually utilized Fingolion to Fingolion's full potential. However, Tabata may be saving it for a big moment, because it could happen next chapter that he achieves Saint Stage. Who knows? But so far, just based on this chapter alone, I would say Lucifer used a Salamander better than Fingolion, because he just slaps him with it. It was embarrassing. A very tragic sight to see with a character with so much potential. But speaking on potential, Dorothy has that potential as well. Her glamour world magic is just insane. The amount of potential to imagination is endless. She can literally create a galaxy in her dream world if she wanted to. She can create space and could just toss Lucifer in there. But the problem is that she couldn't even activate her dream magic because Lucifer just smacked it out of there. And every time any captain did anything to Lucifer, he just said pointless. And it reminds me of the whole Miraliona situation when she was fighting Raya. When every attack Raya was sending at her, she was just burning through it saying next. Now the tables have turned in a dramatic way. Now, when I saw Seke in this chapter, by surprise, it just made me think, what is Seke's role this arc? Because the original crew that showed up to the Spade Kingdom, they all had a role. We saw it. We saw it with Vatos and Sally, the Snowman. But we have not seen Radies and Seke. They're the only two that showed up originally to this arc and haven't done anything. Maybe Radies is there just in case if anyone dies, he can just resurrect them. But he has to be in a deep connection with them. So I'm not sure how that will play out. And if Seke is there just for comedy relief, then I would just accept it. Now, I'm not exactly sure what Charlotte tried to do with her Briar magic, because we know that she has that special ability, like that anti-curse spell. But whatever it was, it just seemed as though Lucifer just crushed her with his gravity. Now, the dialogue from Lucifer, it reminds me so much of Veto, because he said that they should be despairing, and it just seemed as though Tabata took a page out of the Sea Temple art. But I do want to see more unique dialogue from Lucifer, but given the fact of his circumstances, he really haven't had the time to talk much, because as soon as he showed up, he's getting jumped, so we gotta be patient with that. But I love how relentless Tabata showed Miraliona in this chapter. Despite her arm getting crushed, she was not giving up. Unfortunately, when she tried to attack Lucifer again, this time it seemed as though her arm is completely gone. Whatever Lucifer did to deflect her or push her back, her arm is gone. And this is really bad for Miraliona, because the way she fights, she only uses her hands. She doesn't use long range attacks, so she's not very versatile. She's one dimensional, but that one dimensional fighting way is very powerful. It's extremely powerful. However, without her arms, she'll be handicapped. Now, she cannot be like Fingolion, because Fingolion, he gained an arm by the Salamander. So this would be very bad if Lucifer was to tear off her other arm. Because we see that this fight is definitely going to continue next chapter, because they are all getting up and ready to continue round two, I guess, for Lucifer. And you see that Real, he is smiling, so he is getting more inspired and more inspiration from this fight, because they all said that they have been given the title as the strongest, and they're trying to show that against Lucifer. However, Lucifer is the strongest devil, so this is the strongest group versus the strongest being. And then the chapter ends off where we see Oz is saying, you don't know what it's like to be a magic knight, and he's ready to do a sneak attack to Lucifer. Now, when I saw this panel, I immediately thought about the situation when they were fighting the Third Eye in a dungeon, where we had Nozell, Jack, and Charlotte versus Fauna, Raya, and Veto, and Oz, he was going to jump in, but but Nozel told him that you have no place to be on the battlefield. This is a battlefield for the captains. You're going to slow us down. And then we had that cool moment when Asa did that sneak attack to Paltry, which surprised everyone. Now Asa can contend with the captains because he is on that level. His sneak attack was successful against Paltry. However, I don't think it will be the same given the fact that this is Lucifero we're talking about. Lucifero could break Asta's sword, or the second gate devil could jump in, who is 100% fully manifested, and stop Asta from sneaking Lucifero. That would be surprising. But we have to wait till next chapter to see how everything plays out. However, leave your thoughts in the comment section. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Be sure to check out my other anime and manga content. You guys have an awesome life. Take care of yourselves. Stay blessed, and we out.